NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 61 in our series, Create a RubyGem, NerdDice. And in this episode, Lord willing and the creek don't rise, we are hoping to release 0.3.0 of our gem. It's been a long time, January 2021. It's now September 2021, since this has been, since we've had a release and we've had a lot of functionality come in. We are through our issues here, the 0.3 milestone. All of our issues associated with that are closed, and we are ready to take a look at the final finishing touches, things like moving the changelog changes to the release and making master blank, stuff like that. So the other thing I'm going to do is take a look at our dependencies and development dependencies on rubygems.org. So especially your dependencies, let's make sure that secure random has not been modified. It has not. We don't need to update that. Let's take a look. Well, most of our other items are related to RuboCop, which probably has been updated. We'll take a look at Coveralls Reborn and SimpleCov. I'll just pause and let you know if there's any updates. So the non-RuboCop gems involved here have not been modified. We'll take a look at our RuboCop ones. They have been modified, so let me just pause and update the versions, see how much of a lift it's going to be to modify the code to be updated, and if it is, then I'll just revert back. So all four of these have updates. We'll try doing a bundle update to the latest. Save the file. No offenses. I think those are both fine, so we'll add those in to our YAML file. We're good. Shattering there. And now take a look at our change log. So we will take these blank added changed fixed items. Move them to master. And then we will create a release version. For 0.3.0, this is 2021. sure that I didn't do anything super weird to the markdown. That's what we want. So I think we can try committing this. And write the message. So we've got our commit here. Let's sign it. All right, let's try building this. Gem build. All right, pause and enter my phrase. So we've got our gem. In our root directory, let's move it. Let's compare it to the other version. So size is increased to 35K, but a lot of code and features have gone into that, so that's not a concern for us. What I want to make sure here also is that we can still install with high security. That is an uppercase P. Seems to have succeeded. So push to master. Make sure our build still passes on the version we wanted to release. Wait for our build to finish. And of course it failed. Total dice, secure random, and it failed by a small amount on the ratio. Let's update that. Give us a little bit more leeway here and update this to 2.1. Want force push to master here, hopefully unfailing our build in the process. Let that finish. All right, now we have a passing build. Commits are all verified. I need to remove my old gem. Move that to the package. Pushing it. Successfully registered it. Let's take a look at it on RubyGems. Working, our version is published. Now let's try that high security install again via RubyGems rather than my local. Just take a few minutes for the gem server to catch up here. I'll try it again. Now it worked. Cool. So yeah, it just took a little while for the timing on everything. So now we need to tag our commit. So we'll validate our log. That's what we want. And then we'll tag our commit. So git tag v0.3.0-a --sign. Got our tag. Push our tags, got a new tag. Now we need to go into our list here, and we need to explicitly on this tag create a release off of it. Choose create release here. Pause and write my release description. So I've got my release, publish it. So now it shows as the latest release. I go to the release there, we've got that. Go to commits, they're all verified. tags, they're all verified. So we're in good shape now. We can everything is up to date. So the next thing we do is generate our checksums, and we'll bump the version in master. Take a look at our checksums, make sure they match what's published with the gem. So, yeah, they got a 30F99058. 30F99058. So that matches. And then got our SHA-256. We will go to our version, bump it to 0.4 on master. Commit message. Simple enough. We will push to the remote. Ensure that our move this to done. Of course, the build failed. Ooh, everything failed. So let's take a look. Everything failed. That looks like it's a not our fault failure. Let's see if we can. Retry the build. We still failed. Let's make sure there's not something weird in that last commit. So we added the checksums. And we modified the version, and that's all we did. Let's see if I can find out what's going on here. So it looks like the issue has to do with the gem file change that we had. Let me see what happens when I try to run bundle install locally. Aha. So that's the issue, is that the version of NerdDice changed. I need to run bundle install before I do that. So let me amend my previous commit. The file. You see, I didn't have a build in place the last time I upgraded this, so I didn't realize that would cause a problem. We'll sign it if necessary. So we should be good now. We're gonna have to force push. Try it again. Let the action run. Oh, now what? Everything passed except for the benchmark, which made it all the way to the end. We'll just update that too. That looks like a garbage collection issue, so you can see the difference between the rehearsal and the non-rehearsal versions of that. In fact, in terms of execution time, I don't think that the BMBM version of this is actually helping us at all. So I'll make that change as well. Make both of these equal to 30. Find and replace. Benchmarks. Run my benchmark. It runs faster now. It doesn't give you the table's not as pretty, but I don't really care about that. So now I will remodify my commit after I add the note to the change log. Write this. So I've got a change. This item here had this, so now we've got our new commit message. Do another force push. And we are finally green on our first commit toward 0.4.
Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.